Hey, I'm Tom, Managing Director for ITQ in Belgium and Luxembourg. VMworld Week, and we are very excited about that. I am very fortunate to have Maarten Kous, end-user computing architect at ITQ Leuven, as a guest. And we're going to talk about end-user computing at VMworld 2021. Great technologies, customer cases, and Nerdfest demos. Maarten, I'm very happy to have you around the table today. You've been part of the community and the end-user community in particular for many years now, so you must have special, very special feelings with VMworld. What does VMworld mean to you?
For me, VMworld is the biggest tech event in a year. It really allows you to get up to date about all the latest VMware technologies, but also just the tech industry in general. This year there are over more than 1,000 sessions, so it's going from customer cases, product demos, the latest and greatest technology, but also deep dive Nerdfest demos. What else do you want? So there is really something for everyone.
Yeah. In particular for digital workspaces or end-user computing, what is triggering you the most at VMworld this year?
This year, really, everything is about being able to work remotely. So everything about anywhere workspace. And of course, zero trust security, because let's face it, security is one of the most important things currently in the industry. On the other hand, there will be a great adoption of everything virtual reality based. They will announce XR Hub. What does it maintain? Normally, if you play a laser shooting game or any VR related things, you often walk around with a big large computer on your back, or you're attached to a desk or to a cable. Now with the latest XR Hub, VMware makes it possible that you directly from your headset can stream data from within the data center. So if you want to architect something, or you just want to work in virtual reality, let's say just have a meeting or reply to emails, that's all possible with XR Hub.
Yeah. Nerds will be nerds anyway, huh? Maarten. But you also mentioned security. Now, in the last year and a half, due to COVID, we've seen that a lot of companies have facilitated their users to work remotely, to work more flexibility. And one of the biggest concerns that has always been part of that was security. So how is VMware addressing this concern? How is VMware providing the digital workspace technologies on one hand, and mixing and matching that correctly with security, making sure that users still have a very good user experience?
Yeah, one of the ways, first of all, is we work in it from many locations, multiple devices indeed, is first of all, of course, how can we make sure that the device is trusted, secure, and up to date? We can manage it with unified endpoint management, and that just as long as you have an internet connection, we always know what the status of your device, so that we're 100% sure that the device is safe that tries to access the data and corporate apps. On the other hand, of course, you have the employee who tries to access the corporate apps and data. We can check the user's identity with Workspace ONE Access and multi-factor combined. So with that, we also can check that you are who same that you say you are. On the other hand, if we also leverage artificial intelligence with the acquisition of Carbon Black and Workspace ONE Intelligence, we can even see when a security threat happens, we can take automatic action on that. How awesome is that?
Yeah. So with VMware Workspace ONE technologies, we bring trusted users and trusted devices and trusted applications together and help maximize security. Did I understand that correctly?
That's really what it's all about. It can really help customers help build their zero trust workspace and still enabling employee experience.
Yeah, that sounds awesome. Shifting gears, you are also actively participating at the VMworld this year. One of the things you're doing is you're part of a roundtable together with Brian Mathern and other end-user computing specialists. And the roundtable is called Back to Our Future, the Community Roundtable on the VDI Admin Role Development. Why should attendees watch that particular session, Maarten?
everything about the VDI admin role over the past years has really changed. It's no longer just only about updating my golden image and my applications and installing Windows updates. No, it has completely shifted with security, people that must be able to work from any device, any location. Identity is becoming more important. Windows 10, everything about Zero Trust. We go all over the place, but it's a great session. You just have to attend it to get up and speed what all the requirements are to be now a VDI admin.
Yeah, I have already booked my virtual seat for that session, let me reassure you. But I'm pretty sure out of the 1,000 sessions, there are a couple of other digital workspace related sessions that you would like to advise our viewers to watch, right?
Yeah, every year we have the end-user computing keynote. Now this year we not only have one, we have two digital workspace keynotes where you can see everything about anywhere workspace, Zero Trust, but also the latest and greatest what I just mentioned about the XR Hub. There you really have to pay attention to that one. But besides contacting us on how to get started with the Zero Trust approach, Peter Bjork, also a security principal architect at VMware, also has a great session, is how to get started with Zero Trust, because Zero Trust is not only something to adopt in your digital workspace, but it's actually just in anywhere in your data center.
Yeah, and I heard that he did it again, Johan van Amersfoort, he did it again. Together with one of his community friends and experts, he has put another Nerdfest demo together, right?
Yeah, really. For me, this is also one of the sessions, if you don't have time to watch a lot, but this is one of them you must watch. Why? Because they will really show you live how you can, if you open up a device, how you can enroll the device into Workspace ONE and in Access. But that's all quite normal, but they go really above and beyond because they also trigger automated steps with API calls and everything with the Hub Assistant and everything. It's really next level on what's even just possible with the technology if you just set them up right.
It's lovely to hear how enthusiastic you are about all this. Thank you very much, Maarten. You hear it, a lot of exciting things also around the digital workspaces at VMworld. Technologies, customer experiences, Nerdfest demos. Make sure to enroll for VMworld if you haven't done so. Last chance. Make sure to subscribe to the ITQ YouTube channel also to watch more IT conversations. And if you need help, we can help you build your Zero Trust workspace. Don't wait any longer and get in touch now and make sure to enjoy VMworld.